A wave is a disturbance. A disturbance that carries energy through matter or space.
Toss a pebble into a pond and one can see the nature of a wave. It's a bit tougher for students to understand the nature of the electromagnetic spectrum and that light itself behaves like a wave. Jean-Pierre Gauthier used the power of light waves to create a kinesthetic artwork display at the Akron Art Museum. It was his artwork that inspired this project. Observation of and experimentation with these electromagnetic waves has shown that they have predictable properties. And it is those predictable properties that are so important to us. Here, then, is your goal and focal point for when the students ask why they are learning stuff they'll never use about waves. The reliable property of these electromagnetic waves makes it possible to develop practical applications for humankind. We know what the wave will do, so we can put it to use. We can make these waves work for us. For that reason, understanding the electromagnetic spectrum waves was included in the Ohio State Standards and is a valuable thing to be teaching. This unit is designed to support and focus your lessons. The two specific concepts addressed in this module are that the electromagnetic spectrum is a range of energy wavelengths with visible light included, and that waves are affected by the mediums through which they flow. But electromagnetic waves don't need a medium at all. This module includes a short video to help you introduce the electromagnetic spectrum. Also included in the module is a teacher sheet about the spectrum followed by a student formative question sheet as an introduction to the learning process. PowerPoint notes are next. They are designed to help both the teacher and the student as they tackle the subject and vocabulary. The first hands-on lessons has your students create a solar panel to learn the best materials for transmitting solar energy. Full instructions and data sheets are included. Students are led to begin thinking about radiation that is reflected, transmitted, and absorbed. Supplemental and enrichment activities are included, along with a summative evaluation. This part of the unit wraps up with a research paper and poster presentation. The next lesson connects wavelength, frequency, and sound. Students use a slinky for this project, which helps them understand waves visually to supplement what they have learned academically. They examine how waves create music. They will also use musical instruments and bubble solution to understand better that a wave moves through a medium without moving the medium itself. Student handouts, PowerPoint notes, rubrics, and vocabulary sheets are all included to support the teaching. By the end of this unit, students should be able to explain why they are learning about waves, that light is a wave and part of the electromagnetic spectrum, that the wave energy of the spectrum does not need a medium through which to move, and that frequency and wavelength create sound. For more help, please go to westernreservepublicmedia.org/ubiscience.